Welcome dear students on our lecture series on design of steel structures, and in today's lecture we are going to discuss a numerical problem on design of gusseted base. The problem is a column ISHB 350 at the rate of 0.710 kN per meter subjected to a factored axial compressive load of 1850 kN. Design suitable bolted gusseted base to rest on concrete pedestal with bearing capacity of 10,000 kN per meter square and bolt of diameter 20 mm. Use Fe41 grade steel and 4.6 grade bolts. So what we have to do from the problem, you can simply understand that we have to design a bolted gusseted base. That is the first thing, right? And second, the bearing strength of concrete or the bearing capacity of concrete is directly given to us. And we have to design the connection using 20 mm dia bolts. So from the given data, we can have an idea that what we are having. So the given data is design factor load 1850 kN, bearing strength of concrete, it shouldn't be FCK, sorry. It shouldn't be FCK. So you can just leave it. Then next, that is ultimate stress of bolt, that is 400 newton per millimeter square for 4.6 grade bolt. And lastly, ultimate stress of steel plate, that is Fu, which is 410 newton per millimeter square. Now what we have to do? So number one, calculate bearing strength of concrete. So it is already given in the problem, so no, there is no need to calculate it. So bearing strength of concrete is 10,000 kN per meter square. And as we have to deal in the newton per millimeter only, so we are writing bearing strength of concrete is 10 newton per millimeter square. So what we have done, if you don't have any idea, then I am just writing it for that. Multiply it by 10 raised to 3. So it will change into newton, and divide this by 10 raised to 6. So your meter square will change into millimeter square. So if you will solve it, what will happen? This will and this will get cancelled out with this only. So your this parameter will become 10 only. So 10 newton per millimeter square only, right? So this is the first step that you have to do. Second, what you have to do? Calculate required cross-sectional area of the slab base. So A required is nothing but design factor load upon bearing strength of concrete. So how much it is? Newton upon newton per millimeter square. So it is 1850 into 10 to 3 divided by 10. It is coming around 1,85,000 millimeter square. So your required area is 1,85,000 millimeter square. So now what you have to do? You have to provide a section in such a way that your length and breadth or your cross-sectional area is more than, sorry, your length, it is more than 1,85,000. So this is your 1,85,000. So provide a cross sectional plate of cross sectional area whose this length and breadth have a cross sectional area which is how much, which is more than, this is your, sorry, this is your length and this is your breadth. So this area should be more than 1,85,000 only. Right, now come to the next step. So in the gusseted base, you have to provide a gusseted plate. So let's look at over what we have written. So what you are having, you are having this gusseted plate. So this is nothing but a gusseted plate, right? This is your ISHB section that we have already mentioned, and this is an unequal angle section. This unequal angle section is 150 by 115 by 15. Means this leg is 150 because we have to connect bolt over here, that's why it is 150. This leg from here to here is 115, and the thickness from here to here is 15 only. So this is 150 by 115 by 15 only, and the thickness of this gusseted plate is 16 mm. So if you look at the length of the gusseted plate, how much it would be. So the gusseted base would be having length L, which includes your, sorry, this should be H. So this includes H plus twice of this. So what we have written, look at this step. So depth of section plus 2 of TG plus 2 of angle leg plus 2 of projection. So here you are having ISHB 350, and for ISHB 350 your H is 350, your TG we assume as 16 millimeter, so it is going to be 2 times of 16 plus 2 times of 115, which is the shoulder leg. I didn't treat the projection over here because I am going to calculate the projection. So it is coming around that my length should be 612 millimeter. Now what I am saying, that instead of 612, I am providing 620 millimeter, and because of that I can calculate the projection. So this entire length is 620, and out of 620 what I am doing, I am providing a projection of 44 millimeter on both the side. So in the end what you will be having, so if I want to write it, so you can see this is my projection, which is 4 millimeter, that is the first thing. This is my leg of angle, up to this point it is 115. Then this is my 16 millimeter and this is my 350, right? So together we are going to have a length which is 620 millimeter. Now if you know the length and you know the total area, you can easily calculate the width of the base plate or breadth of the base plate. So area upon length, you are getting around 290, so I am providing 300 millimeter. So together I am going to provide the length of 620 and the breadth of 300 millimeter. So this is all about. So what you can do over here, you can directly assume some projection, you will be having the total length, so you can skip this particular step. There is no need to do this step, you can directly assume some projection, there is no problem. Is it clear? Now come to next step. So now you have decided the length and breadth. So now come to next step, determine the intensity of pressure W from the concrete pedestal. You know that it depends on the factored load and the area of the base plate provided. So how to get it? So this is what we are having. So this is what we are having, right? So this is the W, which is, this is nothing but your length, this is nothing but your length, this is nothing but your breadth, and this is nothing but your PU, which is factored load. So this is the length which is in contact with the concrete box. So this is the length, right? And this is nothing but the width of the concrete box which is in contact. So this part will be having some pressure, and this pressure is nothing but 9.94 newton per millimeter square, and you can conclude from the step number one that it is more than, sorry, it is less than bearing strength of concrete, it is less than BSC, which is bearing strength of concrete. If it is less than bearing strength of concrete, then there will be no crushing of this concrete box. So this you can remember. So after this, what you have to do, you have to determine the thickness of the gusseted base. So how to determine the thickness? For that you have to remember this particular figure. So it depends on the pressure intensity W and cantilever projection. So how to get this cantilever projection? You have to assume a critical section which is located over here, which is located at the face of the angle. So this total leg is from here to here, this leg is from here to here, it is 115, right? This leg is 115, and if you look at this leg from here to here, it is 150. So vertical it is 150, horizontal it is 115, and this cantilever projection is how much? This projection is 4, and this length is 115, right? So what you can write over here, that your x value is 115 plus 4 and minus 15. Because why we have deducted the 15 over here? Because the thickness of this particular section, the thickness, this thickness is how much? This thickness is 15 millimeter. So this total length is 115. So 115 minus 15, you will be getting this length, which is 100, and 100 plus 4 will be getting the projection, which is coming around how much it will come? It is coming around 104 millimeter. So actually what you are having, if you want to understand it more in much better sense, what you are going to have, you are going to have a cantilever something like this, and the pressure which is acting over here, it is W. So you can consider the unit width of the plate. So the unit will change from kilonewton per meter square to, sorry, from newton per millimeter square to newton per meter only, right? So now you are having a UDL whose intensity is W newton per millimeter, and it is acting over this length. So now when you are having a cantilever which is having a UDL of W, you can, you simply know that the moment which will be acting over here, how much it will be? It would be W into X into X by 2, right? So here W, this is how much? This is nothing but X. So W is the force into X length. It will be acting at the X by 2. So that's why we are having W into X by 2, which is nothing but W into X square by 2. So how much movement is going to come on the critical section because of this upward pressure? It is coming around 53,755 Newton per millimeter, because this value was in, why it is in this unit? Because this is in Newton per millimeter square, and for unit width it would be in Newton per millimeter only, and it is in millimeter square. So Newton per millimeter multiplied by millimeter square, you will be getting Newton per millimeter only. After this, what we have to do? So now look at this figure again from other point of view. So what we are having, again this figure. Now this total thickness we are knowing from this step. So what we are going to do, we are going to calculate the moment resisting capacity, or say just bending capacity of this particular section. So this particular section which is having a thickness, so now what you can assume like this. So what we are having actually, if I am going to talk about this particular part, say I am drawing this part over here. So what you are having, as I told you, you will be having unit width only. So you are having a rectangle whose length is, or say width is, this is how much, let me write it, this is only 1 millimeter, or say 1 millimeter, and you are having this thickness. So this combined thickness means the upper part is angle and the lower part is base plate, means this total thickness, right? This total thickness is how much? T. So when you are having a rectangle of width B and thickness T, you can calculate section modulus as, your section modulus Z is nothing but, I can write it over here, the Z is nothing but, it can be written as your moment of inertia I divided by Y only. So your moment of inertia is BD cube by 12. So your B is 1 into your depth is how much? Your depth is T cube divided by your Y by 2. Y is how much? Your depth by 2. Your depth is T by 2, and it is BD cube by 12. So if you solve it, you will be getting this formula only, which is T square by 6. So I have the, my moment adjusting capacity of this section is how much? T square by 6, sorry, 1.2 into Fi by gamma m naught into Ze, which is T square by 6. So your value is coming around 45.45 T square. So now you can have the capacity is equals to applied moment. So your applied moment was 57,000 something, and your capacity is around 45.45 T square. So if you put both the value, then you will be getting the thickness around 34.4 millimeters. So this is the thickness which you are having, which is total thickness from this angle to the base plate. Now in the next step, what we can do? So look at the next step. So this, the total thickness of the T includes the thickness of the gusseted base and the thickness of angle, which is T angle and TB. So TB can be calculated as T minus T angle. So you are knowing from the previous step that your TB is T minus T angle. T angle is already 15, that you are knowing from the step number third, and T is 34.39. So you are knowing that your TB is 13.93, and you can put it 20 millimeters. There is no problem. And you can also write that provide a base, gusseted base of length 620, width 300, and thickness 20 millimeters. So this is the size of base plate that you have, sorry, gusseted base that you have designed. Now in the last, you have to design the connection only. So how to design the connection? As we have to design the bolted connection using 20 millimeter diameter bolt. So that's why we are going for bolt value. So for 20 millimeter diameter bolt, the bolt value is always 45.27 kN for single shear. So this is, you can remember, because we are not going to solve the bolt value over here. So you can directly remember that for 20 mm diameter bolt, your bolt value is 45.27. Now assuming the column end and gusseted material have the complete bearing, so 50% of the load will be assumed to pass directly, and 50% of the load will pass through the connection. So Now we have to design the connection only for 50% of the load. So how to do it? So look over here. We have to calculate the number of bolt because we have to design the bolted connection. So for 50% of the load, we have written it 0.5 only. So it is for 50% of the load. So my design load is, it is in kilonewton, and my bolt value is also in kilonewton. So my bolt die is coming around 20.43. So I am going to provide a uniform number of bolt for the symmetry. So let us provide the 22 number of bolts. So what I have done, I have arranged 22 number of bolts in this manner. So the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21, 22. So these are the 22 bolts that I have arranged on each face of the gusseted base. And in the last, you have to draw this figure from both the sides. So this is the length, which is 620 millimeter, and this is the width, which is 350 millimeter. So if you are having drawing also in your subject, then you must draw this figure. Sorry, if you are having length drawing, then you must draw this figure. This is 620, this is 300, and you must also determine the pitch over here. How much is the pitch? Because if you will compare with this, then this is not going to be right. So you can compare the pitch also. How much is going to be pitch? How much is going to be your gauge? And how much is this angle? And how much is this length also? Right. So all this you must do as a practice only using Pythagoras theorem, because this is known to you. This is 300. This is also known to you. So in the end, you can have the design parameter with you. So if you want to conclude in the last, that what you have to do, so you have to calculate the bearing strength of concrete. It is already given. Then calculate required cross-sectional area of this slab base, then determine the size L and B, then determine the intensity of pressure W from the concrete pedestal, determine the minimum thickness, and design the connection. What you have to remember over here, that in this particular step, you have to consider the thickness of gusseted plate, which is on the side of the ISHB section. You have to consider the ISA, which should be unequal angle section, whose shorter edge is connected with the base plate and the longer edge is connected with the ISHB section. Why we are going for unequal angle section? Because if the section is something like this, so if your cantilever is less, then the bending moment also will be less, and therefore the thickness requirement will be less. Is it clear? Because if this X length is less, then what will happen? Because of this X length, your moment, which is W into X square by 2, is also going to be less. So if your length is less, then what will be happen? Your moment will be less, and corresponding you have to provide the less thickness. So you must always go for the unequal angle section whose longer is connected with this part, because over here you have to connect more number of bolts. So if you are having the more length, then you can connect more number of bolts. So this is all from my side. If you have any doubt, you can post me, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.